Okay, so I got all the hoses that I can reach under there undone. Got a bucket full of bolts and clamps. Got those transmission ones undone. I drained the tranny filter housing. But as you can see, you can't get the plug out. So I had to undo the clamp up there and then take a pry bar to the bottom to get it over far enough to get it out. So I posted on my Instagram and Facebook page about trying to lift this out. Had a lot of really good guys make some comments on there. And they figured out, I had three of them. They figured out the distance and the load. And I ended up calling Zach. He's got a YouTube channel called Zach Life down in Texas. Talked to him for a minute. And it was kind of nice because I always wanted to talk to Zach. Zach's got a motorhome. It's a Peterbilt with a 1693 in it, and he's built it. Guy's a smart guy. Anyway, he's got some oil wells on his property and just does a lot of cool stuff. So it was really great talking to you, Zach. Anyway, it's been kind of interesting because I found that practically every bolt everywhere, I don't even have to hardly push, especially the lines and stuff. I use those anchor clamps. I put the wrench on there and get ready to bear down and just go voop. So nothing was tight. They like to use a lot of baling wire everywhere. I don't know why. Baling wire to hold up wires. So here's the two bolts that have to come out, and there's a couple spacers in there, and that just don't look right. Usually there's shims in these, but with those big spacers and there's nothing on the other side, it's pushed clear over that way, so things may not be lined up correctly. So as far as the lifting mount goes, pretty much I showed him a picture, and I'll show you. Here's a picture of the Cat tool, and can't really tell if that's angle iron or channel iron, but everybody's talking about using channel iron. And Zach had it all kind of mapped out. Channel iron is in pounds per foot. So, and that makes sense because in my scraper floors, when you build them, they use 20 pound per foot ship channel that sandwiches between the upper and bottom plates. Anyway, he had it figured out to go from 9,000 PSI or pounds, I think up to 12,000, depending on the pounds per foot channel I used. Anyway, I'd like to try to build one like the Cat tool, like it shows in the book. Okay, let's see if I can get this one out. Sweet. This has got a nut on it. Wow, that's bent. Something wrong there, Jeff. Get the wrench on her. Let's see if I can hold it. Oh, there went the nut. Ooh. Wow, that's got some stress on her. So I got the other one done with an end wrench. They weren't even tight. The back one, since it had a nut on it, I just impacted the nut off of it. They're new bolts. They're just not even tight though. Question is how do you get this out of here? Oh, good morning. So I got the U-joint out, did it by hand. It wasn't that heavy. But generally, when you take these out, at least machines I've worked on, you got about a 2 foot long 3/4 wrench. I was telling you before, Dad bought one just for this. It was a Craftsman. Just had a box end on one end and then a bar that came up. And you'd take another wrench and put on one of these and let it go down against that valve. And then, boy, you'd grab that wrench to undo those. And when you tightened them, you really torqued these down. I took these off. I thought, I'm never going to get it off with these 2 3/4 inches. So I put one on there and ran it against the valve, grabbed a hold of that one. I thought, boy, I'm going to have to really hork. Boop. Not one of these bolts, none of these were tight. This thing ain't been greased forever. It's full of rust. So I'm going to have to replace the joints. And then the other thing that they've done wrong here, in my opinion, is you've got a grease fitting there. This joint should be oriented, so your grease fitting is going to end up here or here. So when you turn it around to grease it, you can get them both. And you don't have to grease these very dang often. I can't remember the last time I greased Killdozer, because they don't really turn. And one of the other things that I noticed is it doesn't have the straps on them to hold the cups together. Anyway, what a mess. What a mess. Okay, so I've spent the better part of the afternoon trying to get my crane running. Been talking to Frank on Signal. That's a cool app. Anyway, can't get any fuel pressure to come out the lines. Took the cover off and checked the whatchamacallit deal. It moves freely in there, metering, stem, whatever, but it's just not getting any high pressure. Like I said, been talking to Frank, thinking about undoing this hose and then figuring out some way to hook another hose on it to come out and figure out how to put some really high pressure fuel into this vane pump. So the way these work is there's a cam ring in here and two plungers, and as it goes around that cam ring, it plunges, and then there's a distributor in there, and as that rotates and lines up with the correct port, it squeezes fuel. So it's an injection pump with only one plunger, basically. And apparently, if the cam ring pushes those in the inject position, the fuel pressure in there should push them back. So I'm hoping if I put some high pressure to it, it'll push them back. It's one of the drawbacks to a stinking Rosemaster Standine fuel pump, I guess, is when these things sit and you got old diesel in there, they'll stick. They'll get gummy, I guess. They're a pretty tight tolerance. But it was running, I don't know how many years it's been sitting here. It was running before it would start up and run pretty good. This is an old International with pre-cups and glow plugs. It'd be the same engine that's probably in a 560 International diesel tractor. So I don't know what to do with it. I'd like to try to get it going to lift that motor out if I can. But it's like I'm fixing one piece of equipment to go fix another one. So what a bunch of crap. So I gotta put my tools away and go out and water the runway. It's trying to rain a little bit. So not much work done today on the D9. It's 9 o'clock. I just dumped a load of water on the runway, filling it up so I don't have to do that tomorrow. Anyway, It's a beautiful evening. Got lots of dark clouds over here. I don't know if it's gonna rain or not. It's black out here, but yet in this phone it takes pretty good pictures. I'm surprised. That white water truck shows up really well. Okay, I'm back out here at it today. I told Jake, I says, if I can't get this to work, I'm giving up. And he says, no, you won't. You never give up. That kid knows me too well. So I can turn on the pump, and I'm not getting any free flow of fuel out the return, even with the check valve removed. And my understanding is there's a passageway up in there. These are self-bleeding. So if you've got supply pressure to the vein pump, there's a passage in there that will push all the air out and come out here. And I'm not getting anything through there, so something's wrong. All right, so I took the end of the vein pump off, cleaned the check valve out, cleaned the screen out. I don't know if you can see it, but there's the rotor. And the vanes aren't stuck because you can take the outside of the rotor and roll it all the way around. The vanes go in and out. And there's a, what do you call it? Here, pin, roll pin, that has to go in that outer rotor to hold it still. So the only way I found to do this is come up and out through the bottom is way I, or I mean down through the bottom to get this in, if I can remember. Boom. So it pumps quite a bit of fuel. Uh-oh, cell phone. And it's here in Texas, St. Clair. Carlin. Hello. Hang on to your butts. So, sounds like I've about run the battery down. I took the jumper cables back up. So I got one injector loose up here, and I'm just not getting anything out that injector. All right, so I'm gonna do something here. I'm gonna open this top up, I'm gonna suck the fuel out, and I'm gonna pour a can of seafoam in there. If it ruins it, it has to come off. Probably gonna have to come off anyway. So, that diesel feels bad stuff, old bad stuff. is gonna work. What do you think? Diesel fuel and seafoam with a little iced tea. Yeah, baby. See, I don't think that's never gonna get to those plungers, I don't think. Okay, I got that hose really jammed down there. That should drain everything out of it now. Yep, that diesel fuel there. Yeah, baby. No deeper. That really drained her down. It's probably gonna take all I got here to fill that. Yep, she's gonna take it all. She's gonna take it all. That's it. Well, it's up to the hole. I may have to go down and get another one. I'd like to suck that out and do it again. Keep doing it till I got the diesel out and there's nothing but seafoam in there. I don't know if that's gonna clean the stuff out or not. Doesn't really look like it's taking it off, but maybe it's gotta sit for a while. I don't know. Alrighty then. So I have sucked all the diesel out and poured it with seafoam, put it in there and blew it through. When I blow, I can get some stuff coming out of here. What I do is I stick it in there and then crank it at the same time, and I can get some out of there, which makes no sense. If those plungers were working, you'd think it'd come squirting out of all of them. I got them all loose. I kind of think the plungers are stuck. We've drained all the old fuel out. It smells like rotten gas. And then I got about 15 gallons of smelly fuel out of it. And then this is the water separator. I got paint thinner in there, and even paint thinner doesn't want to hardly eat it up. I put seafoam in there and it wouldn't take it off. That paint thinner actually, if you rub this hard, it does come off where it's stained on the glass. But then it had a screen and stuff. I took that out and cleaned it up. But I just don't think this is going to do anything. I think the plungers are stuck, and probably the only way to fix it is take the pump off, get a gasket, seal kit, whatever, and take it out. If the plungers are damaged, they'd have to be replaced. It's not that complicated to take that pump apart, as long as you don't mess with any of the screws or adjustments. Put everything back the way it was, it should work. I don't know if I want to spend any more time on this or not, though. Okay, end of day two. I have given up. Like I say, the only other thing I could try is put high pressure fuel in here, see if it could cut them loose. That'd be my last resort. After that, forget it. That'd have to come out and come apart. So, back to our regularly scheduled D9 program. Have a great evening.